Do you like travels?
Yes.
I love travels. Why do we like travels? Yes, in travels we meet new people, we discover new places and cultures. Is that all?
Yes.
I don't think so.
You know something?
Maybe there's another thing. Maybe people like traveling because they get away from their troubles. Because when you go traveling, then you start to think about different kind of stuff. So the thing that which makes you feel bad about it, you will forget at least that duration of time. So maybe this one of them.
Yes, you are right. Also in travels, we get the opportunity to know ourselves, to face with our peers, to discover our strengths and weaknesses. Actually, we grow through travels. For that reason, I find that travels are amazing and mysterious experiences for us. 4 years ago, my mother was very ill and I was very sad. And I decided to go my childhood city to Kahramanmaraş and visit her. When I was arranging my trip, my son came to me and said, "I want to come with you, mommy." I was surprised. He was 18 years old and it would be a mother-son trip after a long time. When we were preparing our trip, I said my son, "Ekcan, I have a feeling that this trip will be an exciting inner journey for us." He turned to me and said, "Mommy, please don't leave. You are always turning everything into a spiritual thing. It will be an ordinary trip. We will board on plane. We will eat our snacks and we will have a small chat. After 1 hour later, we will be in Kahramanmaraş. That's all." I said, "Okay, you may be right. We will see." As we arranged, we were on the plane. We ate our snacks and we had a small chat. After 1 hour later, our plane started to climb down and down and down for landing. As we reached to the ground, suddenly, it started to climb up. We were shocked. We were on the sky again. And our pilot was announcing that, "Ladies and gentlemen, please calm down. The ground was very foggy and we couldn't land. After 20 minutes, we will try it again." We thought that it might be a normal thing. And after 20 minutes, he tried again and he couldn't land. During the travel, he tried 5 times in every 20 minutes and he couldn't land. Can you imagine? It was like a roller coaster. We were flying down, we were flying up. Generally, I am a calm person. I was calm, but the other passengers was getting anxious, and I looked at my son, who was in panic, and to calm him, I start to talk with him. After 1 hour later, the anxiousness in the plane was getting intense. In every trial, we were breathless and we were praying. I carried on talking with my son. We talked about our fears about that, about our future plans, our regrets and hopes. Our small talk was getting deeper. And after 4 hours later, our pilot decided to give up trying and announced that we will land in Adana. After landing Adana, we thought that it was over and we were relieved. We got on a bus arranged by Turkish Airlines to Gaziantep instead of Kahramanmaraş. They are near cities. And I thought that there was a crossroad in the middle of the road, and I thought that it would be a shortcut to get off the bus and on the crossroad and get another bus. And our bus driver supported my idea and said, "Sister, yes, there is on the highway there is a path. You can easily walk down and get another bus to Kahramanmaraş." We got off the bus on the highway. For a while, I stayed and watched the view. We were on the top of a big mountain called Nur Mountain. it reminded me of my childhood trips with my family. We used to pass through this mountain when I was a child. I was feeling happy and safe until I saw the big cliff in front of us. There was no an easy path, even a path. It was like a nightmare, and everything was getting worse. And my son started complaining about everything. For a while, we lost our reality. What we found ourselves lovely. What are we doing here? On the top of a big mountain. And after a while, I turned my son and said, "Please stop complaining and focus on finding a solution. My son, life is like that. We learn and grow in difficult times. We can over it together." And when I was talking, I fell down from the cliff. And my son grabbed my arm, and he saved me. all my clothes were in mud, and we started to walk down slowly and carefully. We were still near to that, really. eventually, we reached the main road. When we were waiting another bus to Kahramanmaraş, we were laughing each other, and my son said, "Mommy, at the beginning of the trip, at the beginning, I couldn't understand the meaning of inner journey. But now, I figured out how an ordinary flight could turn into a dangerous mountain adventure." And at that very moment, in front of my eyes, I realized that my son has visibly changed. He faced his fears and discovered his strengths and weaknesses and become a man. Thank you.